Well, folks, next week is Mike Lindell's not anticipated 96-hour stream-a-thon, where he is going to, in his own words, lay out a state-by-state case for how the 2020 election was stolen. Now, if you're like me, you're wondering, okay, why the hell didn't you do this during your previous three-day little summit? You know, your cybersecurity summit that you had back in August in North Dakota, I believe it was. You were supposed to give us all the evidence then, but instead all we got was a PowerPoint with a bunch of random numbers that you guys had just made up. You didn't have any actual evidence. You didn't show us any kind of documents that showed anything was stolen. You didn't show us those servers and those routers, the packet captures that you totally said you had. And so everybody knew at that point you were a fraud. So Mike Lindell, during an interview this week on Steve Bannon's podcast, the recently indicted Steve Bannon's podcast, he goes out and he says this. This is Article 4 of the Constitution. The guarantee clause requires the U.S. to guarantee the states a republican form of government and provide protection from foreign invasion. That's just one smidgen of the case. Ah, yes. That legal term smidgen that I hear all too often from all of the lawyers I work with. Then he says that the Supreme Court is going to have the option. They can either, quote, pull down the election or do a new election without machines. The Supreme Court will have a lot of decisions to make. For 96 hours, we're going to take apart the case. We're going to do a state by state. How did we get here? And then Bannon says to him, the machine guys are saying, Dominion and Smartmatic, are saying Mike Lindell's crazy. There's no evidence. And then Lindell shot back. He said, we're in a race. And we're winning this race, Steve. We're winning this race. We really are. More and more is getting exposed every day. Cool. But he was actually trying to get you to respond to the fact that, like, they say you're crazy. What do you say to that? And I say, I'm in a race. Okay. If somebody says, hey, man, everybody thinks you're crazy, the response to that is not, I'm in a race. Because it really makes you seem, you know, well, crazy. I know I have my personal opinions about Mike Lindell, and if Dominion and Smartmatic are saying that he's crazy, far be it from me to disagree with him, right? That guy hasn't shown me anything that gives me any kind of faith in his mental competency. But here we are. Just a couple days away, Mike Lindell swears he's coming out there. He's going to give us all this evidence. And here's the thing that gets me about this, folks. Anybody who believes Mike Lindell and Steve Bannon and Donald Trump and all these people, and there's unfortunately a lot of them, a growing number, like it's actually becoming more people. Why the hell hasn't Mike Lindell introduced this evidence to get the $1.3 billion defamation lawsuit against him dismissed? If he has the evidence, all they have to do is turn that into the court and say, listen, their defamation case is baseless because here's the evidence to prove what I said. Then boom, case dismissed. Mike Lindell, you don't have to pay any legal fees and you don't need the discovery process because you already have the documents that show that what you said was true. See what I'm saying? Like, you don't need to move forward at all. But the thing is, you don't. And I think that you've dug yourself so deep into this hole that you legitimately don't know how to get out of it. So you just said, screw it. I'm going to keep digging. I'm going to keep going with this. What's the worst that could happen? Well, the worst that could happen is what legal experts are saying right now, and that you probably are going to lose your company. You're going to lose so much money on these lawsuits, you will physically not be able to pay it, and you will be forced to either hand your company over to Dominion, or you're going to have to sell it to be able to raise the funds to pay off the Dominion lawsuit, in which case the company is going to end up in somebody else's hands. You live the rest of your life destitute. For what? A couple minutes of fame? Trying to kiss Trump's ass a little bit more? Hope it's worth it for you. Because this is one case you're definitely not going to win, just like every other lawsuit you've been involved in this year. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.